Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.
Nachiket Panchvaidya, CEO at Old Balaji and Group CEO at Balaji Telefilms, joining us on the show. Welcome to the show, Nachiket, and happy to have you as well. My first question coming to you is that, you know, these have been unprecedented times for, you know, sectors, for all economies across. However, one thing that I've noticed is that, at least in terms of FY20, it's been one of the best years for Balaji. So there is something to cheer about as well. What would you actually attribute this kind of growth to?
Well, there are two aspects to our journey over the last 3 years, and I'm just taking a step back. We decided to kind of own our digital future 3 years ago by starting this platform, Alt Balaji. We were, till before that point, we were largely supplying content to broadcasters. They owned IPs and we were in a cash profit business. But we started creating this value proposition going B2C 3 years ago. Every year we have doubled our revenues from 15 crores to 40 crores to 77 crores. And in the next, 9 months to 12 months, we'd also have a break-even quarter, which means that we are creating a business model that is not just a bottomless pit for our OTT business. So that is one part because of which, you know, we've seen this swing. Our losses on the digital business have halved from the first half to the second half of the last financial year. They've gone down from 68 crores to 37 crores. And that loss making on OTT platforms is something that is helping us swing the business around. In addition to that, we've had a good year with TV. Our movie business has also got rationalized. Our movie business is largely predicated right now on pre-sales and ensuring that, you know, the theatrical distribution only accounts for anywhere between 20 to 25% of our fate. The rest of the business is already taken care of, and we have taken care to see that digital, satellite, all of that contributes before we even finish production of the movie. So I think we have rationalized our business, created a framework where we are well on our way to be self-sufficient. We are a zero debt company with about 250 crores of cash with us, and we are very, very well positioned to explode giving the digital future of India. The result of this is that we have swung from a minus 100 crore EBITDA to about a plus 11 crore EBITDA in the last financial year that ended. And we hope that, that momentum is at least maintained in this financial year. Of course, the exception will be the 4.5 months of COVID where we didn't have production. We will catch up in the remaining, remaining seven and a half, 8 months that are there.
Right. So, Nachiket, you know, a lot of industries that we've been talking to, the question always has come up that due to COVID, the revenues that we have lost in the first half of the year, because it's a given, it's already the month of August now, some industries will be able to recoup those lost revenues in the second half of the year. Do you think for a business like yours also, there is a possibility to recoup at least on the top line front in the second half of the year?
Well, it is difficult because part of our business is actually television production. If you don't have television production for 3.5 months, you can't make it up by, putting on the same in the rest of the year because it's a continuous production business in a sense. So on the television front, I think how we will recoup or how we will try and mitigate the losses by increasing volume. So if we did, for example, 7 shows last year, we will attempt to do 10 shows this year and try and maintain at least the top line of last year. On the movie production business, one thing is there that of course no movies have been produced, but we have pre-sold all our movies. So we are kind of assured of a certain profit at the end of this. So that's not going in the minus. The television business will also stay positive because we will kind of garner more volumes. What remains to be seen is how can we accelerate the growth of Alt in the remaining months. So while there has been a large amount of subscriber inflow in the last 2-3 months, we need to retain them. And to retain them, you have to put on new shows. And I think that is the opportunity as well as the challenge for us going forward.
Right. So in terms of where Alt is concerned as well, Nachiket, when we say that we are going to generate more content on that front, is it going to be mainly in-house content, or do you think it could even, you know, accommodate outsourced content on Alt Balaji?
So let me just give you an insight into our business production model. We never acquire movies or acquire licensing.
Correct.
Primarily because we want to own our IP and we want to control our digital fate. The primary reason for starting off Alt was that we wanted to own our space. Otherwise, for others, we've always been making television programs which are hit, and you know, broadcasters have been enjoying the benefits of that also to some extent, and it's been mutually beneficial. So therefore, we will not acquire and we will not do stuff where, you know, we are not in creative control of our fate. That is one. Secondly, I think what is extremely important for us is that the costs of acquisition are extremely high. Today, if you want to acquire a movie, it's anywhere between 50 and 100 crores for digital, you know, a reasonably large movie. Our annual programming budget, where we make about 25 to 30 shows every year, is 100 to 120 crores. So in that one movie cost, we can do annual programming and deliver roughly, you know, 150 to 200 hours of content and form a habit with our viewers. So for us, our economics is largely predicated on creating shows, creating habit-forming shows. So we don't have any episodic shows. All our shows are linear, which means one storyline goes into another. And that habit formation is the reason why our revenues are doubling year on year at a cost base. That is something that's very manageable.
Right. So with this, if you have to take, say, the digital consumption into consideration, because if I talk about FY20 as well, all Balaji's revenues have almost doubled. Now, if you have to look at FY21, now due to the lockdown, the consumption, as you mentioned, the subscription has been higher. Retaining the subscribers is going to be key from here on, and that will all depend on the kind of content that you pull off. Now, with that, what's the viewership we are looking at right now? What's the kind of time spent that we are looking at right now?
Well, I mean, in the lockdown period, the time spent has, you know, literally doubled. It's gone up from roughly around 30-40 minutes to double that. And therefore, there has been a consumption of library also. What is really important is that in the lockdown period, we've been exposed to newer markets, especially in tier 2 and tier 3 towns of India. Pre-lockdown, our distribution was about 60% of our revenues and therefore subscribers came from the top 8 metros. Now, 40 to 45% only are coming from top 8 metros. And I feel, you know, that's our sweet spot. Our sweet spot is the fact that there are many, many competitors today catering to top 8 metros. But that accounts only for 5 to 10% of India. We are uniquely positioned to enter tier 2, tier 3 towns and address that large mass India audience. Also because we are at a very affordable price. We are at 300 rupees a year and 100 rupees for 3 months. So it's like a rupee a day. And that price makes us very, very affordable for people who want to see good, mass entertainment. And the benefits of COVID really is that without having to spend money on customer acquisition and marketing, we've been exposed to a large, subscriber base in that market. Our opportunity actually is to now crank up our production starting August and launch shows so that we retain those new customers who are kind of coming. And that's going to be the interesting thing. And I'm quite confident that we'll manage to, you know, keep the run rate clip going year on year.
And any trend, Nachiket, that you witnessed with regards to rural versus urban consumption right now? Because a lot of industries have seen a rise, at least from the, you know, rural markets right now. Is that a trend that we are seeing in the entertainment industry as well?
Well, overall in the entertainment industry, of course, you know, there have been trends which are different, but let me talk about the way Balaji is seeing where we are going. Our television product always has been consumed rurally. We always have a large base. But digitally, because we are a pay platform, I think tier 2 and tier 3 cities. So what I mean? you know, you can pick a Rajkot probably. I'm not very sure whether that's tier three, but you know, those cities are the next catchment area for us to get our subscriber base doubled. That's primarily because we are a pay platform. I think free OTT is really what is dominant in the you know, rural areas right now. But as months go and as our library goes up, I think in a year's time, we will also be entering the rural space in a big way. Right now, we are in tier two and tier three towns.
Right. And right now, on the back of COVID, what's the sense that you're picking up? You know, if you have to compare the present situation to, say, probably a year down the line, how is the future of the media industry expected to change on the back of COVID? And for, you know, Balaji as well, between TV, films, digital, which segment do you think will be the next growth driver if you have to take a three-year perspective?
Well, it's at best a trick question. I don't think anybody in the world can really predict what's going to happen a year down the line. But let us see some, you know, initial trends that emerge, at least from our business perspective. One is that we at Balaji realize the world is going digital. Therefore, even our TV business, if you see, we make Kum Kum Bhagya, Kundli Bhagya, we make Nagin, they're ad on broadcasters, but they're also ad on the OTT platforms of broadcasters. So we have to be conscious that this concept of, you know, television business being different from OTT business is something that is old hat. Anything that goes on ZTV also goes on Z5. As a matter of fact, it's offered on Z5 and Hotstar before it goes on television. So it is, in fact, a digital product. Our movie revenues are highly dependent on digital platforms. We have to also create movies thinking that ye digital platform pe jayega, because about a year ago, only, you know, say 10% used to come from digital. Now 30-40% of our revenues are coming from digital. So it is literally a forced disruption on our lives that digital has to be the growth path. One part of our digital future we are fully owning through Alt, which is our main thrust digital platform. We have a B2C platform. We create original content for that. We make 25 shows. We are doubling revenue. So we are very, very well positioned in the value proposition for digital. And now we are also under the realization that everything is digital. The world is becoming digital. The proportion of digitality, if I may, in viewership is increasing every year. So if it's television, television product goes on digital. If it's movies, it's viewed digitally. The new trend is, of course, that they're premiering on digital as such.
Okay.
If I were to kind of give two strategic areas for us, one is the recognition of creativity for digital, and second, it's growth.
Right.
Nachiket,
with this, you know, there's always been, a devil's advocate here, where, you know, when I speak to the PVRs and the Carnival Cinemas of the world, they've always been on a tip right now that, you know, how can production houses release big budget films on the digital platform? And, you know, the question has always been that I think right now, at least currently, we will have to understand the situation and go by with it. And then what the consumption trend looks like with the consumers is what everyone's going to adopt. What would your view be on this?
Well, right now, we haven't released any big budget film on digital so far. Our film is Dolly Kitty or Go
Chhod. Yeah.
It's really a small budget film. The big budget films and their costings, we will have to work out when the situation improves and theaters open. We don't know whether there'll be alternate seating, you know, alternate seats left empty during theater seating. We don't know how F&B revenues for theater systems will go up. And therefore, our business model from Balaji's viewpoint is that we want to see this emerge before we start investing, you know, heavily in big films. Till then, I agree. I mean, the focus seems to be that we want to be in, you know, 20 crore kind of budget films, not the 100 crore, 80 crore films. The situation becomes a little more certain. For others who are releasing it directly, I guess they have their own, you know, they've already started the film. They have their own economics to look after. In releasing it directly on OTT, given the lack of theaters opening. I think in the new lockdown 3.0 also, theaters are not being open. So I think once that situation becomes clear, then our investment has to follow. Our main thrust is actually to grow our value on our alt platform and ensure that our cash cow business, which is television, goes and continues to be profitable. Our movie model right now is to ensure that we don't make losses. You know, historically, 2-3 years ago, we were making losses on movies, but that's been reversed. So therefore, we want to create a solid business on you know, three pillars, which is movies, television, and digital, which moves towards EBITDA positive line. So if we can create a business of that sort and position ourselves as the number one content player in movies, you know, who's across movies, television, and digital, that gives us a very, very good and unique positioning in the mass space today.
Right. And with this, you know, now that we're talking of all Balaji as well, we're talking of the production. Do you think on the back of COVID, there is a possibility that production by taking, you know, different things into consideration right now, and that somewhere could impact profitability as well as on the margin front, not only for Balaji, I'm talking for the industry as a whole?
Well, the industry is a different thing because I mean, my belief is that the costs at which industry produces, we are producing it at probably, you know, 30 to 40% of their cost or average half an hour price. We don't mount large scale productions which cost 3 crores an episode. You know, our average episodic cost is around 30 to 40 lakhs an episode. So there are two aspects to it. One is that I think our data shows that our product, which is between 30 and 50 lakhs per half an hour, resonates most with the masses. So in terms of COVID, of course, there are some inefficiencies that will creep in. But the flip side is that our ability or our desire to, you know, start traveling and shooting at exotic locations itself is going to be curbed by COVID. Whatever shooting are there are going to get counteracted by the fact that you are forced to shoot in limited number of locations, in limited places. So I can't say that, oh, come on now, let's go to, for example, UK and, you know, do a schedule. So in a way, our production costs are going to be balanced out. Whatever efficiencies arise because of, you know, stopping, starting, sanitizing, disinfecting and taking all the measures will be counteracted by the fact that you cannot be extravagant in choosing locations till there is a vaccine and, you know, all of this goes off. I don't know whether creatively that necessarily is a good thing, but at least from a pure cost point, to answer your question, I don't think our costs will go up because there's that balancing factor.
Right. So, okay. That balancing act, as you're mentioning, correct, comes its way as well. So from here on, what do you think is the movie pipeline and the television show pipeline going to look like?
For Balaji?
Yes, for Balaji, for this year.
This financial year up to March 31st, 2021, we don't have any major movies to release. So this year we are sure of profitability. We have already released our movies and we will definitely book profits. And we have done that as a conscious decision because there are uncertainties in this business. It's not like we have started a movie and put in 100 crores and we don't know what to do. We haven't done that. On the television business, we will try and, you know, see whether we can, we can mitigate the lower volume. That is because of the first three and a half months of COVID. And on the digital front also, we will try and maintain whatever we have done last year. At least be at that level in terms of bottom line. In terms of top line on the digital front, we are looking at growth. What that growth will be, we'll be able to tell only probably in about a month and a half's time as we finalize our production lineup. In terms of number of shows, we will try and do about 20 shows in the remaining months to be released, anywhere between 18 to 20 shows. And TV shows, of course, we will have 6 TV shows, probably moving up to 8.
Right. So that's a strategy with regards to the shows that we will be seeing. Now, with old Balaji as well, Nachiket, what has been the consumption pattern with regards to male versus female consumption? Any numbers that you have on that front?
It is 70% skewed towards male subscription. So let me put it this way. That the subscriptions are 70% male. However, it depends on the show. Like if we make a show like Apparent, there's a large male skew. But if you do Kehne Ko Humsafar Hai, or if you do Barish, or if you look at data for those shows, there is a distinct female skew. So because there are 5 devices that are given free with every subscription. The payment is made by the male member in a 70-30 ratio. Correct. But the viewership goes varies from show to show. Our subscription focus is definitely 70% male.
Right. And with this kind of, you know, increase in subscription, increase in viewership that's coming in for Alt, do you think the investment strategy could change where if we were looking to invest X, we could increase that right now?
Well, we are always, you know, debating how do we, you know, what is the time for the big scale up? Mm. Right now, we are good. You know, we are profitable. We have got a proven business model. We've got enough data to focus our programming strategy on Mass India. When we started off, we were pretty much urban mass, but now we've come down from urban mass to mass. And we've changed the nature of our shows. We've dropped kids programming from our, you know, from our bouquet. We are very, very focused and centered on being the number one Mass India player on the in the OTT space. How do we blow it up? I think that will happen when we are closer to around 90 shows on the platform. Right now, we have 62 shows. So probably in a year's time, we are in a position to completely enlarge this. Our first priority is to retain the consumers that have come in during COVID. And probably in a year's time, we want to scale this to 4x, 5x of the size that we are currently at. What is also heartening is from in the last 3 years, our acquisition cost per subscriber has gone down considerably from about 130, 140 level to, you know, less than 100 today at around 90. Mm-hmm. So I think as we add our library, that acquisition cost is also going down. And we will trigger scaling up when we feel that the acquisition cost is sufficiently low, library sufficiently large. My guess is anywhere in the next 9 months to 12 months.
Right. You know, I'm just going to ask you one last question on the same thing. It just comes as a thought right now that because of the lockdown, when we're seeing the subscribers increase now, a lot of people, because they've been locked down in the house, viewership content is increasing for OTT platforms. But once things start to open up, once people start getting back to normalcy, do you think that could be a double whammy situation where we could see a drastic drop in terms of viewership for content?
Well, you know, it's not, unfortunately, habit formation is such that to reverse a habit, it's very difficult. You know, so if you are kind of now changing from one medium to another, to quickly change back, you need a compelling reason. Mm-hmm. I feel one of the compelling reasons for people to go back, you know, to television screens, of course, is going to be series programming. But the attrition that has already had to happen on television has happened in these 3 months. So 100% of those viewers are not going to go back to, you know, television. Some people are going to stay back with digital. Not only that, one must remember that as long as broadcasters continue the strategy of showing the same product on both television as well as digital, that reverse attrition may not happen. Because you're getting the same show actually even before it's telecast right on digital. So having built a digital habit, there is no compelling reason. It's the same show that you're going to see back on TV, right? So why would somebody quickly, you know, shift? The issue there is, you know, even for sport in that matter, you know, even if there's live cricket today, you can see live cricket on the OTT platforms already. Yeah. And I guess in all over India, people are now open to individual choice. That's the real big shift. Mm-hmm. Earlier with one TV, you were forced to watch what one or two family members wanted in a 4-5 member family. But now people have understood the power of the mobile phone, which is individual, you know, choice. And even in television shows, the male representative of the family might want to watch something different from the lady of the family. And they can watch it on mobile. So I feel it's a trend that will change only if there is distinct programming available on television. Till then, if you can see the same stuff simultaneously or before, you know, I think this change is to stay.
Right. And lastly, Nachiket, do we see all Balaji breaking even this year?
Yeah, I did start off the interview by saying that in the next, 9 to 12 months, we will have one quarter of break even.
Super. So that's going to be good news as well. And thank you so much for joining in. It was a pleasure speaking to you. Great insights that we picked up. And I think I'm going to catch you soon once you start releasing new episodes as well to understand more about the platform. Thank you so much. And I hope you enjoyed the conversation as well.
Thank you so much. That was very good. Thank you. Oh.